On behalf of the Monetary Board, I'd like to thank you all for gracing the 2024 annual reception for the banking community within these walls of Fort San Antonio Abad. I am especially delighted to join you in this yearly tradition because tonight's celebration is a very special one. This year marks 75 years of central banking in the Philippines. It is fitting that we gather here at Fort San Antonio Abad. This fort, together with Intramuros, was designated a national cultural treasure by the National Museum of the Philippines. It played a significant part of the history of Manila, and similar to this fort, the BSP has come a long way as a central bank from its inauguration on January 3, 1949. Due to the leadership of visionaries who recognized that the BSP must change with the times and the painstaking efforts of the men and women of the BSP who made this happen, we are all here today. The BSP started as a central monetary authority in 1949. It later assumed the responsibility for regulating the financial system. And then in 2019, we were able to inscribe in our charter our three fundamental mandates: maintaining price stability, financial stability, and a safe and efficient payments and settlement system. Through all these years, the BSP has managed to be a source of stability for the economy. We are not resting on our accomplishments. We deeply feel that we still have work to do. Indeed, we have outlined a reform agenda. It is an ambitious agenda, and we will need your help for most of it. Let me just mention four goals in this agenda. First, we want to further enhance our monetary policy framework by sharpening our research, our models, and our monetary tools. We want these to be more responsive to inflation pressures, particularly during periods of unusual and large supply shocks. So far, the BSP has managed to anchor inflation expectations and thus effectively control second-round effects. Through our inflation targeting framework, headline inflation has gone down to 3.9% as of December 2023 from a high of 8.7% in January 2023. Second, we will strengthen the way we conduct systemic risk oversight. We will see, you saw what happened in March 2023 with Silicon Valley Bank and Credit Suisse. We don't want this to happen to us. And for now, the banking system remains healthy, characterized by strong balance sheets, profitable operations, and sound performance indicators. The banking system likewise stood firm and proved its resilience through the pandemic and through the international disruptions of March 2023. Third, the BSP's financial stability mandate also carries with it the responsibility to deepen our capital markets. This is meant to diversify the sources of funds in our financial system so that our businesses and our investments do not have to rely entirely on the banking system in case there is a credit crunch. Fourth, we will strive to make the BSP's sustainability initiatives more meaningful by infusing it with an inclusion perspective. We want to ensure that the financial system supports an inclusive adaptation program so that the burden of transition doesn't fall on the most vulnerable segments of our society. Parallel to this, the BSP is harnessing digital technology to empower sectors which have been traditionally underbanked. We think our open financial framework will unlock opportunities for consumers. The BSP has been relentless in bringing our Paleng QR PH Plus program to various parts of the country, giving market vendors, public transport drivers, and other merchants a more convenient way of accepting e-payments for their transactions. So the BSP has accomplished a lot in the last 75 years. None of these would have happened without the help of various stakeholders present here today. To the past members of the BSP Monetary Board and BSP officers, we salute you for helping shape the BSP into the world-class organization that it is today. Meanwhile, I hope that through the initiatives which we will put into play in collaboration with the banking industry, the BSP will be able to contribute to a brighter and better future to our countrymen.
No, naman, no. Within the year, but maybe first semester is too soon. But we'll see when the numbers. Pwede siguro. Yung lalabas yung the latest inflation number, the one for January. Ano kailan ba yon? Tuesday yata, no? Next Tuesday. So it's likely to be a low number because of base effects. So you have to kind of adjust for base effects kasi the January number will be measured relative to January 2023. In January 23, ang taas noon, 8.7% nung January 23. So because of that, the number that will come out in January might be a bit low. And then babawi yun, no? Babawi yun sa second quarter. So second quarter numbers may be a bit high. So we have to adjust for that.
So when you say second quarter numbers will be a bit high?
A bit high only because of base effects, not because inflation is really high.
It's going to be above 4%, sir.
Hindi ko alam. But maybe, yeah. I think if there are no further upside risks, bandang ganun siguro.
Governor, do you have an indication how the last quarter
I don't know the exact numbers.
Do you think it's going to be better than the Q3? Or what's
Yeah, I think it's going to be better than Q3. Yeah. Seeing Q2 medyo aberration yun eh. So, in terms of growth, no?
Right.
Yeah.
So, if that's the case, how will that impact the policy outlook?
Well, if the growth is strong, that gives us a bit more room to hike.
Last
question.
To hike?
No, to hike kasi strong growth eh. So kaya ng economy na tanggapin.
Okay. Last question.
So you think, sir, there's still room for further?
We're kinda in the zone where it's kinda neutral whether we this is based on our estimates of what's called the natural rate. But the natural rate, we estimate, our estimates are very imprecise. So, which means we could hike and it's still okay. But we're not sure because it's an imprecise.
Would you say that the central bank is still on a hawkish mode?
Oh yeah, oh